Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2098, Custom List Limits. This is just a bizarre one. Don S. Using Mac 2011, right? So we're not even using the real version of Excel. We're using the fake version of Excel. We're trying to sort by a custom list, but it's only accepting the first 38 items in the list. And I know that's wrong because Excel can handle up to 254 items in the list, or at least that's what I thought. All right. And Don has player name, number of wins, and then margin, like how far off from the score were they? So the proper sequence is the perfect score is 0, and then over by 1, under by 1, and then over by 2, under by 2, over by 3, under by 3, and so on. And Don is trying to sort the margin column by this custom list. Now, I've never tried that, but hey, it should be easy to do. So over here, proper sequence, 0, 1, and then the formula is going to be minus the value just before us, and then equal the number 2 above plus 1. All right, now that I have those two formulas, I should be able to cruise down to row 201, too far there, but that's okay. And we should have the exact sequence that we need down to 99 and minus 99. So there's our perfect set of answers. I'm going to copy that. So Control C to copy and then paste as values. Paste as values like that. All right. So I should be able to set up a custom list that will handle this, right? No problem. So we go to File, Options, Advanced, scroll 83% of the way down, choose Edit Custom Lists, and we will import that list. What? Cells without simple text were ignored. You're not allowed to have a custom list full of numbers? But Don says this is working for the first 38. What's up with that? Well, after thinking about this for a while, I realized that Don must not have been trying to import. He must have just been typing those numbers into the dialog box. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do Control-C to copy all those. I'm going to go to Notepad and paste into Notepad like this, Control-V, and then select everything, Edit, select all, and Control-C, come back to Excel, File, Options, Advanced, 83% of the way down, Edit Custom Lists, and I'm going to type that list in here like it's Control V. All right, and that all works. But we click Add. The maximum length for a custom list has been exceeded. Only the first 255 characters will be saved. And when you look at this, sure enough, they are creating a custom list that only goes down into 38, minus 38, 39, and then bam, the minus 3, right? So this is so bizarre. They're actually letting me create a custom list with numbers, but they're not allowing me to get 255. I mean, it works. It works. And then if we actually try and sort over here, so we'll say data sort and sort on this custom list, the one that only goes to 39, click OK, click OK. Well, if it's in the list, it sorts correctly, right? So the positive sixes show up before the minus six. But then once we get down to anything beyond 39, it's just going to sort into a sequence that's not in the list. So it's going from smallest to largest here. So someone who missed by 67 points is better than someone who missed by a positive 42 points. It's just completely screwy, right? And what's up with this only going to 38? Now, sure, there's every other number. So, you know, I guess it's going to down into the 30s. We're getting down to like there, right? Or there, one of those two. So what is that? That is a total of 78 items. And hey, I know that you're allowed to have 254 items because I talk about custom lists all the time in my seminars, right? You have 254 items. Here, let me show you. So item space 1. Of course, we can use the fill handle for that. I'll drag down to 254 like that. Now, those aren't formulas, so we should be able to do File, Options, Advanced, go down to Edit Custom Lists, and we will import that list. All right, there it is. Bam, no problems. No error message. Everything is great. Everything is... It's not great. It only goes to item 234. Wait, I know you can have 254. Why is it stopping at 234? That's bizarre. That's bizarre. What's up with that? So here, we know that it's only going down to item 234 right there. Okay, now, when we were typing the items in the list, there's some number of characters that was the limit. So I wonder if there's some number of characters that's the limit here. Equals sum of the length of that whole bunch of stuff. Press Ctrl+Shift+Enter, and it's 1764 characters. 234 items. And I know that you can have 254. I've done this before. And let's try something crazier. All right, so let's try this. Let's try, instead of item, let's try something longer. So 10 characters, a space, and the number 1. We'll go down to 254 rows. And we'll try and import this list. So File, Options, Advanced, Edit Custom Lists. We'll import this list. No error message. Seems like it worked. But it only goes down to 140. What the heck is up with that? What is the limit? I thought it could be 254. So let's see how many characters we have if we get down to 140. All right, so we'll delete everything else after this. And in fact, I'll come over here to this formula and copy the exact same formula over. All right. Now, at this point, I'm pretty exasperated with the Excel team. What's up here, 1764, and here, 1852? Hey, Microsoft, what is the limit? Exactly, what is the limit? Ah, but here's the thing. They must be storing this as a series of delimited strings, right? So they're taking all the items, and then they're adding a comma after each one. All right, so here, since we have Office 365, we can use the new text join, so equal text join of all of those with a comma in between. I don't know if it's really a comma or not. Ignore empty, true, comma, and these items. So we get that, and actually I just want to know the length of that whole thing. So the length is 1997, and when I do the same thing over here, 1991. Oh, so clearly the limit must be 2,000 characters, including a invisible comma between each item. This is all pretty bizarre. All right, so I always thought it was 254 items. It's not 254 items. It's 254 items, provided it's less than 2,000 characters, provided the items aren't too long. All right, so just to test my theory, let's just use A space 1, like that, and we'll grab the fill handle and drag. These should be really nice and short, because, and we'll go down to 254. Let's go to 255 to test it. All right, so now with this, if I ask for the length of the text join, $14.21, yeah, it should be no problem at all. So select the whole thing, and File, Options, Advanced, scroll all the way down to the bottom, Edit Custom Lists, click Import, all right, and sure enough, all the way down to 254, all right? So it's 254 items, provided it's less than 2,000 characters, including a invisible comma after each item is how this works. But back to Don's problem here. It sure is annoying that the dialog box, if we just go in and start typing things in the dialog box, instead of having a 2,000 character limit, it has a 255 character limit. All right, so Don has no way to type this thing in, and when we try and import numbers, it refuses to import the numbers. It says no deal, anything that's not plain text is not going to work, right? So the one thing I suggested to Don is an alternate solution. I say, hey, let's just come out here and add a helper column, and this helper column is going to be the absolute value of that number, right? And we'll double click to shoot that down, and then what you're going to do is you're just going to sort descending by the absolute value, ascending by the absolute value, right? And then the 4, 6, and then -6, right? These will all just get sorted together. So it's not bad. I guess what you could really do is you could sort by the helper and then add a level and then sort by the margin descending, largest to smallest. Click OK. And that'll get what Don is looking for. So all of the positive 6s show up before the minus 6, and then 8, and then minus 11, right? You know, but this is a hassle. Like, hey, Microsoft, why do we have to go to all this hassle? Why won't you let us type 2,000 characters into the dialog box? Or, even better yet, since it apparently works to have numbers in the custom list, I mean, it is working here, why won't you let us import it? All right, now, here is the workaround. And I'm sorry that it took this freaking long to get to the end, but this is what I had to go through to figure all this out. So, I'm going to add this workaround column, all right? And this workaround column is going to be the text of that number, in quotes, comma, or quote, zero, quote, close paren, like that. And we're going to copy that down. All right, so now we're taking these numbers here. See, the numbers are right justified, and we are left justifying it by using the text function. Unfortunately, though, you can't use formulas in the custom list. If I would come here to File, Options, Advanced, go down to Edit Custom Lists, and we'll import that. No, cells without simple text were ignored. Okay, fine. I'm getting really annoyed now, right? Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the workaround column, and I'm going to use the Home tab, and I'm going to copy it, and then I'm going to paste and paste values. If you don't do this step, it's not going to work. And here's how to prove to yourself that it works, all right? If those are really numbers, when you do the sum function, it's going to give you an answer like this. That's going to be 5, all right? But if I do the sum of the workaround column, I'm going to get 0, right? And the reason is the sum can't sum text, right? So, these are real numbers, these are real text. You have to get it to be real text. Once you have it as real text, select the whole thing, go to File, Options, Advanced, Edit Custom Lists. We'll get rid of this old custom list here that we don't need. We'll get rid of this list that we don't need. We'll get rid of this list that we don't need. We'll even get rid of this list that only goes down to 38 and 39. And then finally, we'll import the whole list. And this whole list goes from 0 all the way down to 99 and minus 99, and presumably stored as text, all right? But here's the cool, awesome, amazing thing. Let's just come back up and we'll sort this data by name, data A to Z. So now everything is just completely random there. And then we will sort by margin. And the order is going to be a custom list. The custom list is going to be this sequence. Click OK and click OK. And it works the 4, the 6s, the minus 6, the 8, the minus 11. And so on. Now, the beautiful thing about this is once you get it set up, right, it's a hassle to put these numbers over here in the off to the side, change them to text, copy, paste special values, and then import that list. But the beautiful thing is once that's imported, then forevermore in this computer, we're going to be able to sort correctly by margin. So, Don, geez, I think that it's worth it to go through that whole thing. 617 Excel mystery solved. Now, this is a new mystery why this custom list wouldn't work, but this book is full of stuff like this video, just the bizarre, the arcane, and so on. Click that eye in the top right hand corner to buy the book. All right, Don wants to sort by a custom list that is numeric. Will it work? It seems to work. Well, it seems to work for the first 38 numbers, but you can't import numeric cells into the custom list dialog box. Ah, so try and type the custom numbers, or actually, I guess I pasted to Notepad, and then from Notepad I pasted. But then there's this crazy 255 character limit when typing. That must be left over from Excel 2003, right? Because the limit is more than that now. You can have 254 items. Is it 254 items? Oh, it's 254 items, but less than 2,000 characters when you have an invisible column, comma, between each item. Now, we did some math here, text math, with equal sum of the length and Ctrl+Shift+Enter, and then the length of the text join, if you have Office 365, and are on the latest version. Even came up with this workaround with the absolute value for sorting, which will help in this particular case for Don. But I think what Don needs to do, the best workaround, and this is what I told him to do on the YouTube video, put those numbers, 0, 1, minus 1, and A1 to A200, and then in the column next to that, equal text of A1, quote, 0, quote, close paren. That's going to convert it to text. Copy that formula all the way down, and then select that range of formulas, copy, and then after you copy, go to the paste dropdown. So copy, paste, and paste as values. And if you're successful, when you do the sum of that whole thing, it's going to sum to a number that's not, or it's going to sum to zero. It's going to sum to zero. And be careful, don't choose all of your numbers, because your numbers do happen to sum to zero. Now that B contains text numbers, you can import as a custom list. Well, there you go. Don, one of the crazier questions I've ever heard in Excel, and we've uncovered at least definitely one bug in Excel, that the custom list dialog box won't allow more than 255 characters. And then this bizarre thing that they apparently will sort a custom list by numbers, but they won't let you import numbers. All right, so I'm going to call that bug number two. And then this workaround here. All right, so hey, I want to thank Don for sending that question in. And if you hung around this long, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.